Hello everybody, my name is Aaron Saavedra. I'm an on-staff pastor at the Door Christian Fellowship here in Amarillo, Texas. And the point and the purpose of this video is to simply invite everyone who is watching to come visit us tomorrow, Sunday, at the Door Christian Fellowship. At 10:30 in the morning we have services, and at 6:30 p.m. also tomorrow evening, Sunday night, we have services. We also have midweek services on Wednesday starting at 7 o'clock p.m. I know what many people think. There's a lot of misconception of who goes to church and why go to church. Well, number one, the church is a place where God demonstrates His presence. His presence is made manifest to man. It's a place where you and I can go to feel the presence of God, to interact with God in worship, in the preaching of the Word, hearing the Word of God being preached. Now, many people say, well, who goes to church? Well, everybody. Everybody should. But the problem is many people think, and they have a wrong idea of when to go to church. Many people say, well, I've got some things that are kind of out of sorts, and when I get my life together, then I'll go to church. Well, that's never been more wrong than anything else in this world. It's like saying, you know what, I'm gonna go get my car washed when my car is clean. I gotta go when my car is clean, then I'm gonna go to the car wash. Well, that makes no sense. You go to the car wash because your car is dirty and you need the services that local car wash provides. Another one is, you know what? I'm gonna go to a restaurant when I'm full and I'm not hungry. Well, nobody does that because there's a need and there's a place that provides you with the service needed to supplement your need or your lack. And those who are watching, that's the point of church. It's a place where the broken come. It's a place where the needy come. It's a place where the desperate and the hurting come. It's not a place where just all goody two-shoes go and everyone who's got things together come and join together. No, it's a place where those who are hurting, they come and find healing, both physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. It's a place for people who are wandering through life, trying to find the purpose of their life. It's a place where they find direction. It's a place where they find purpose, because there is no purpose outside of the Word of God. It reminds me in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, when Jesus is going and He's calling out His disciples to come and follow Him. Notice where Jesus didn't go. He didn't go to those who had it all together, supposedly, but He went to the places where the rejects hung out. He went to the places, the shores, where fishermen were, and He called them, come and follow Me. He went to the tax collectors, and He says, you know what? Come and follow Me. And those who are watching right now, you might be in a place and say, I don't fit in any church. Look, I got all kinds of stuff going on. I have tattoos. I have, you know, I look different. I don't fit in with the church crew or the class of people that go to the church. But the church is a place made up of people who come from the streets, who come from broken homes, who come from destroyed marriages, who come simply by the abuse of this world and what sin has put upon them in their life. Listen, it doesn't matter how far you are away from Calvary, how far you are away from being good, what the world calls good. There's a place for you in the house of God. And I'm making an appeal to you right now as you're watching this. Whatever you're thinking, whatever you're doing, your life can be changed by coming to the house of God. Visit us tomorrow and experience for yourself. Don't take my word for it. Experience for yourself the plan, the restoration, the purpose that God has for you. Yeah, you. Your whole life you might have been said, you know what, you'll never amount to anything. There's no place for you in this world. You're going to be just like so-and-so. You're going to be just a drunk, just like your father, a drunk, just like your mother. You're going to be a loser, just like your friend. Whatever the story, whatever the accusation, let me tell you, that does not have to be your end. That does not have to be true for you. There is a place for you in the house of God. There is a place for you in the kingdom of God. And I'm challenging you right now. You might be watching this. I'll even pray with you that God would touch you right where you are, and to ask Jesus into your life and come and be part of our family. If you want to accept Jesus into your life, I want you to say these words: Jesus, please forgive me of my sin. I know that you've died for me, and I believe you rose again on the third day. I'm asking you to be the Lord of my life from this moment on. I surrender my life to you. I thank you for your mercy on me, a sinner. And I choose to live for you from this moment on. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, listen, I hope to see you tomorrow, Sunday morning at 10:30. We'll be waiting for you at the door.